fulfill all righteousness. Listen, a Christian is someone who follows the footprint of Jesus Christ. So Jesus himself, he was a sinless God. He was not a sinner. But the Bible says Jesus went into the water. Jesus was baptized. I'm here tonight to say he's my example. If Jesus do it, I will do it. If Jesus say it, I will say it. If Jesus leave it, I will leave it. Will you not say an amen here? A Christian is someone who followed the footprint of Jesus. Matthew 3:16. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. Jesus was not baptized by sprinkling. He went into water. Look at the text again. As soon as Jesus was baptized in the past tense, he went up out of the water. Baptism that Jesus did was by immersion. And the Bible says he saw the Spirit of God. Baptism is about adoption. So immediately Jesus, who is representing us, showing us what God expects from us, immediately he's baptized. This is what happened. The Spirit of God descended like a dove, and there was lightning on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my word." I didn't hear that. "This is my word." I didn't hear that. "This is my word." I want to tell you, immediately we are baptized, God accept us. God receive us. He said, "This is my son. This is my daughter." That is the stamp of adoption. You are adopted. People know you to be sinner. People know you by your sin. People may recognize you by your sin. People will never respect you. But the Bible says, immediately you give your life to Jesus and you are accepted, God adopts you. The adoption means you are saved. The things I used to do, I do them no more. The things I used to say, I will say them no more. The things or the places I used to go, I go no more, because there has been a great change. I'm declaring to the world, I am for Jesus. I'm declaring to the world, there is something that has happened to me. Listen, you don't get baptized if there is not a change in heart. Many people have gone into the waters and they came out as water devils. They were devils before entering. They came out. They were only soaked devils. When it is done rightly, we become sons. The word Messiah means anointed. At that time, Jesus was anointed. He was set aside. And the Bible says in Acts 10, verse 38, God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost. The day Jesus was baptized, the sign that he was received and adopted by God as a symbol on our behalf was that the Spirit of God came. Immediately you are adopted, God gave you the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is that we bore testimony. We are now overcomers. When you used to sleep with women, you will never have the taste to sleep with women anymore. When you used to be so loose to men, never again. When you used to lie, when you used to cheat on your wife, when you used to cheat on your spouse, you used to steal in an example. You do shady deals. There is a new spirit. You don't belong to the kingdom of error. You don't belong to the kingdom of Satan. You don't belong to the kingdom of deceit. You don't belong to the kingdom of hypocrisy. You are adopted by God. Will somebody not say an amen here? The Spirit of God descend on Jesus. And immediately he went out. He was doing good. You will not speak an unintelligible tongues. When he received the Holy Spirit, the Bible says Jesus started saying, "So to. Say me le. Adventure. Next week Thursday, I'm going to deal with that." The Bible said when the Spirit of God came upon Jesus, the Holy Ghost, and with power, what did he go to do? He went out doing good. He began to clean people's community. He began to give them health lectures. He began to do good to people. He began to smile to people. He began to shake hands to people. He began to pray to people. Will you say an amen here? He went out doing good, and he was healing all that were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. When you are baptized, God will work with you. When you are baptized, God will empower will sustain you when you are baptized. God says, he announced to his angel, mark him, mark her, mark him. Be his guy, be his guy, be her guy, be her guy. Because you are proclaimed, I no more belong to the kingdom of Satan. I belong to the kingdom of God. John 4. The Pharisees heard that Jesus was gaining and baptizing more disciples than John. Although in fact it was not Jesus who baptized but his disciples. So something happened. Any evidently heaven approved practice. Immediately Jesus received the Holy Ghost. His ministry began to expand. Not fake ministries. Holy Ghost based ministries. Your spiritual territories. Demons become afraid of you. Devils become afraid of you. The reason is that when you are walking, angels, because you are adopted, they become your watch. You will not go to any palm reader to protect you. You don't need soldiers to protect you from Boko Haram. God, take responsibility. Because you are declared, here I stand. I'm not for Satan. I hate him. I am for you. Before Jesus died, he gave a special message to his disciples. When he died, and he was about to leave, his last message he gave them, when somebody is about to die, or about to leave, and gave messages, take it serious. He said in Matthew 28, verse 8:19, he said, go therefore, and make disciples of all the nations. You baptize them. You do what? I didn't hear that. You do what? I didn't hear that. You do what? If you want to put another word there, I will say you use the word. He asks that they must be adopted. They must be adopted. So go therefore, make disciples of all nations. Let them be adopted. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. In other words, let them surrender to me through my word. Baptism is complete surrender to the Lordship of Jesus. And you teach them. When you baptize them, then you teach them. After you've taught them basic Christian truth and they accept it, he said, teach them to do what? To observe all things. That is why we are not doing a 3-day revival. 14 days. Because God commanded us that when you go, when you teach, you don't teach just that. After they have a price, they accept me, you teach them all things. Behold, I am with you always. But somebody may ask tonight, how many adoptions do we have? If baptism is adoption into the kingdom of grace, into the kingdom of truth, how many adoptions do we have? Ephesians chapter 4. Verse 5, can you read with me? He said what? One what? No, I didn't hear that. He said one what? He said one what? He said one what? There are three. Let's go again. The first one is what? One Lord. The second one is what? One faith. The third one is what? One baptism. How many Lord do we have? One. How many faith do we have? One. How many baptism do we have? One. There are some people today who baptize by sprinkling. It's wrong. One baptism. One method. When you are baptized in Roman Catholicism with sprinkling, in Methodist with sprinkling, no. The Bible says one baptism. If you believe it, will you say an amen there? Amen. You see, Jesus says, I come to testify of the truth. And those who love the truth, they will listen to me. One law. One faith. One baptism. The untold truth. In the book of Acts, an African from Ethiopia gave us an example. A very prominent man. He was searching, like the way some of you are searching. Then he came to service in Jerusalem. And the Spirit of God knew. Some of you, God knew you want to follow truth. That's why he used a miraculous way that you can attend this meeting. It's not everybody in set light that can have this privilege. God knows your heart. He knows you are searching. He knows you are willing. So was this Ethiopian eunuch. He was searching. And he came from church in Jerusalem. He was going home. He was reading the book of Isaiah chapter 53 about who Jesus is, what he stands for, what kind of Messiah he is. So the Spirit of God spoke to Philip. Philip was an evangelist. Walking down the dusty roads of Gaza, he saw the Ethiopian eunuch. So he asked the Ethiopian eunuch, "Do you understand what you are reading?" Some of you are reading the Bible. You love the law. You love the law. But Satan has made sure we follow error. So he asked him, "Do you understand?" And he responded, I'm talking about Acts chapter 8, and I'm reading from verse 30. In verse 31, he says, "How can I understand unless someone guides me?" Some of you want to know God's will, but you need someone to guide you. Some of you want to do God's will. You want someone to guide you. Some of you want to follow God's truth. You need someone to guide you. So God, in his wisdom, he sent Philip to the Ethiopian eunuch who was searching. Like the way he has sent us. Not by privilege, but by right. Not by right, but by privilege, I should say. That we should learn at the feet of Jesus. So he explained to him who Jesus was. He invited Philip to join him. He was a rich man. He was the treasure of the Ethiopian princes. They read the book of Isaiah chapter 53. A prophecy about the Messiah. The Ethiopian invited Philip to explain to him. And the Bible said that Philip began with the very passage of scripture and told him the untold truth, which is the gospel of Jesus. The untold truth about the personality of Jesus. The untold truth about the adoption of Jesus. The untold truth how Jesus washed away your sin irrespective of what you have done in the past. He told him the good news about Jesus. He was convicted. Philip taught him about the adoption. And the Bible bore record. Whilst they were walking, the man was convicted. The same way I'm teaching tonight how to be adopted. I learned it from Philip. Philip did not only teach about the first coming of Jesus. He did not teach about Jesus in Revelation. He did not only teach about who Satan is. He did not only teach about the Bible. He did not only teach about the signs of his coming. He did not only teach about the manner of his coming. He taught the man how to be adopted. So the man says in Acts chapter 8, verse 36, he says, "See, here is water. What can hinder me from being baptized? In other words, what can prevent me from being adopted into the kingdom of truth?" Will you not say an amen here? Like someone will say, after listening to all of these, what can I do? What can prevent me from making that decision? I tell you right now, today I was moving from my hotel and a young lady called me. He said, "Pastor, yesterday you mentioned about baptism. I am ready to be baptized." The Bible says, Acts 8:37, then Philip said, "If you believe," ladies and gentlemen, baptism is not just taking a shower. Baptism is not just entering the water. It must come by conviction. You see yourself that I am a sinner. I have left God. I have followed the world. I am entering hell. This world is coming to an end. I am not living like a Christian. And I want to follow God. If you believe, not partly, with all your heart, the days in which we live, God demands nothing but all. It is all or nothing. Then Philip said, "If you believe with all your heart, you can baptize you." The Bible says, and he answered and said, I believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And Acts 8:38, so he commanded a chariot. He was a rich man. He told his motor kid and his convoy that waits and is too still. Both Philip and this rich African treasure, the Ethiopian eunuch, they went down into where? Into the water. Did they sprinkle the water on him? No. They went down into the water and he baptized him. He gave this man. man to Jesus. That, Father, adopt this African. Adopt this African. These Africans who have worshipped shrines and gods, he has accepted you. Adopt him. And the Bible says, now, after the baptism, they came up out of the water. Who came up out of the water we saw the first time? Jesus. He is a Christian. He has followed the footsteps of his master. Then the Spirit of the Lord caught Philip away. And the Bible says, and this man, he went on his way and he was rejoicing. I want to believe he might be thinking, I'm pressing on the upward way. New highs I'm getting every day. Still praying on as I always want. Or he might be singing, there is a name that I love to hear. I love to sing it well. It sounds like music. Can you give me that song? In my ears. The sweetest name on earth. He was adopted into the kingdom of God because he was baptized. He may be singing that song. I love that song. It's the song about the name of Jesus. Hit me that note and tell me, there is a name I love to hear. The sweetest name on earth. If you know that song about the joy, it says, how I love Jesus. He went away happy. I've been adopted into his kingdom. I've been adopted as a son. I've been adopted as a daughter. I've been adopted as a child. My sins have been washed away. He went his way. He was happy singing. Make a decision like that. Why was he baptized with body, mind, soul? Why did he enter the water completely? Listen to me. We sing with our head. We sing with our eye. We sing with our mouth. We sing with our hands. We sing with our feet. If God wants to wash them, you not only sprinkle water on your head. He needs to baptize the head, the eye, the mouth, the ear, the heart, the feet, the legs. So he was baptized into the water. Will somebody not shout an amen here? Yeah. Baptism all over the centuries has been done by immersion. The first Christians who ran away and were in Cappadocia in Turkey, they were baptized by immersion. You go to the Leaning Towers of Pisa, they were baptized by immersion. No Christian ever baptized by sprinkling before until one day. I begin to teach those things from tomorrow. Dozens of cathedrals were all with baptistry when people were baptized. If you read the book Faith of Our Fathers, the Cardinal James Gibson, the 94th edition, page 277, says, for several centuries after the establishment of Christianity, baptism was usually conferred by immersion. But since the 20th century, the 12th century, the practice of baptizing by infusion has prevailed in the Catholic Church. As this manner is attended with less inconvenience than baptism by immersion. The Catholic Church brought baptism by sprinkling. But it was not the Catholic Church. To Satan. He wants to prevent us from being adopted. The church exercises a discretion in adopting. Because baptism is adoption, the church adopted the most convenient mode against God's rule of adoption according to the circumstances of time and place. And gradually they believe for the children. Listen, before John the Baptist, the word baptism has existed among ancient people, especially those in the Greek land. Baptism means baptism. Can we say baptism means what? Baptism. I didn't hear that. Baptism means what? Baptism. They used to do die. Let me come forward here. If this was a cloth, They are tired of wearing plain cloth. So they will put some dye in a bowl. You want to change the color. I don't know if you have tie and dye in Nigeria. You? Beautiful. Like the way they do the tie and dye. Then you will dip them. You don't take a tie and dye and sprinkle the dye on it. Baptism is from baptizo, where they used to put tie and dye into water. That is what it was. You are immersed to deep, to plunge beneath water. Baptism is a sign that I believe Jesus died. I believe he resurrected. I believe he can give me victory over sin. Jesus never said we should celebrate Christmas. He never said we should celebrate Easter. He never said any of these things. You will never find it in the Bible. You want to remember how Jesus died? He said, be baptized. He said, take the Holy Communion. I'm not saying it. The Bible said that. Let's go. Romans 6, verse 3. Or do you not know that as many of us were baptized into Christ, were baptized into his word, then. If you are baptized, if you want to be adopted, it means you are baptized into the death of Jesus. Therefore, we were buried. If baptism is dying to your sin, have you seen a man dead and they sprinkled sand on him before? They buried him now. Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death. And why? That just as Christ raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so, we also should walk in the newness of life. So baptism means when they hold you and they plunge you like the way they did for Jesus into the water, it means you are saying, I have died with Jesus. You are saying, I will wake up to the newness of life. Baptism is saying, I am no longer in charge of my life. The life I now live is not I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Will you not shout an amen there? One day, an educated man, maybe he was an Igbo man or an Yoruba, he came to Jesus on our Sabbath. He came to Jesus at night, very educated. And listen, John 3, verse 2. He wanted to play with words with Jesus. He said, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher from God. For no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. Jesus answered and said, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus was asking, how can I be adopted? How can I get to God? Like somebody sent me a question. He says, how can I live a holy life? This is the answer to that question. You want to live a holy life? You must be adopted in the kingdom of truth. You want to live a holy life? You must be adopted into the kingdom of grace. You want to live a holy life? You must surrender and be baptized into Jesus. Say amen there. Nicodemus came and said, how can it be? Jesus says, you must be born again. If you don't do it, you cannot. You can't. Listen to me. The Bible means what it says. And it says, God says, they don't do it for you properly, you can't. You go to hell. So Nicodemus asks, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus said, John 3 verse 5, he answered, I say to you most assuredly, unless one is born of water and born of what? Spirit. Baptism is in twofold. Some people have done water baptism. They have not been baptized by the Holy Spirit. At baptism, you are saying, search me, O Lord. And know my heart today. Immediately you are accepted and you are immersed into water. The Bible says the Spirit of God comes into your life. And he says, God declare. He said, this is my son. You are born of the water. And the Spirit of God will come upon you. Like it came to Jesus. And you'll be doing good. People will see you. A change in your life. Jesus said, if you don't do this, you go to hell. He cannot. He said it two times. Enter the kingdom. 16. Jesus said, when we preach this way, whoever believes, whosoever believes, whoever believes, boy, girl, man, rich, poor, tall, short, black, white, whosoever believes, and is baptized, the person will die. Is that what he says? No. The person will go to hell. Is that what he says? No. The person will be what? Saved. You want to be saved? Let me see your hand. Give God a round of applause right now. No, that's a weak one. Give God a round of applause right now. Will you shout and say an amen here? Let me say it differently. Is there somebody here who wants to go to hell? Raise your hand. You want to be baptized? Accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You want to be adopted into the kingdom of truth? Understand the teachings of Jesus. We taught you about the Bible. We taught you about who Jesus is. We taught you about Satan, who he is. We taught you about how the signs of Jesus come in. We taught you about the manner of Jesus coming. Teaching you about baptism. We never took one.